Meghan Markle and Prince Philip may seem to symbolize the new and the old in the royal family, but the Duchess of Sussex and Duke of Edinburgh share a great deal in common, including a heartbreaking decision they both had to make in order to start their royal lives. Meghan Markle and Prince Harry welcomed their son Archie Harrison Mountbatten Windsor this May. The Duke and Duchess of Sussex released a delightful photograph of the new royal baby meeting his great-grandparents the Queen and Prince Philip shortly after they presented their boy to the world. However, the doting new great-grandfather shares more than might be expected with the nation's newest duchess. Both Meghan and Prince Philip had to give up their flourishing careers in order to dedicate themselves to their new royal lives. Prince Philip joined the Royal Navy as a young man from Dartmouth Naval College in 1939. He reached the rank of commander and served in several significant operations in World War II. However, when the Queen ascended the throne in 1952, he was forced to give up his lifelong career. Royal historian Richard Fitzwilliams, speaking to Express.co.uk, explained, "Philip's role as consort is far from the role he would ideally have chosen. In the Navy he would probably have risen high had not the King's failing health forced him to terminate a promising career." Similarly, the Duchess of Sussex trained as an actor from her undergraduate days studying theatre at Northwestern University. She most notably reached acclaim with her role in TV drama Suits, but also ended her acting career just before her marriage into the royal family. In 2018, ahead of her royal wedding to Prince Harry, Meghan said, "I just see it as a change. It's a new chapter, right? And also keep in mind I've been working on my show for 7 years." Indicating Prince Harry, she added, "I feel really proud of the work I have done there and now it's time to, as you said, work as a team with you." And the similarities between the two royals do not end there. Neither the Duchess of Sussex nor the Duke of Edinburgh were born in the UK. Meghan is well known for being a California girl, and even placed Californian poppies in her royal coat of arms to memorialize her beloved home state. Prince Philip was born on the Greek island of Corfu as Prince Philippos of Greece and Denmark. The Duke has Greek, Danish, and German roots, and is descended from Queen Victoria through her daughter Princess Alice, who became Grand Duchess of Hesse and by Rhine. Meghan's nationality means that the Duchess of Sussex has to wait to become a full British citizen, as she has not been resident in the UK for the requisite 5 years yet. She will also have to pass the written citizenship test, just like anyone else applying for British citizenship. Prince Philip had to give up all his rights to his foreign royal titles. He became a naturalized British citizen, and was given the title Duke of Edinburgh just before he married the Queen in 1947. His family name, Battenberg, was also anglicized to Mountbatten, which forms part of the surname we see today for new royal baby Archie. The Duke of Edinburgh even faced suspicion from the old guard palace courtiers, even though he had been educated for most of his life in the UK. However, the Queen was steadfast in her love for her husband, who she had been devoted to since she first laid eyes on him as a teenager.